Imagine a world where we can find a treatment for all diseases with just a small sample of blood. A world where we don't need to study human diseases by using animals, but instead simulate you and your personal disease on an organ on chip to find the right treatment for you. This is the aim we have in mind. We have 15 PhD students working in 11 different institutions across Europe with one common aim: exploring new models to better understand human physiology and disease. Within the European Marie Curie International Training Network, we have been given the opportunity to strive for this aim. Today, I would like to show you what our work is about. The human body is an extremely complex system, which makes it challenging to study diseases on laboratory models only. Animal experimentation offers unique opportunities in terms of tissue and organ interaction studies, with the whole body response to, for example, a given treatment. Although we have learned a lot from animals and our basic bodily functions are very similar, we have known for a long time that information we get from such models is inadequate to predict the outcomes in humans. The 3R principle aims to replace, reduce, and refine animal models. This includes engineered laboratory models mimicking how the human body works, better experimental design and adequate statistical planning, and better protection for laboratory animals during experiments and housing. This is where our new systems come into play. We work on the development and investigation of organ-on-chip models. Organ-on-chip models, or OOCs, are small devices that are around the size of a 2-euro coin and mimic a specific organ on the microscale for research purposes. By creating these devices, we aim to create a research method that is more reliable than the animal experiments carried out currently. Organ-on-chip systems are designed by humans to resemble human organs, to be able to investigate human physiology and disease. Within the ITN network, we work on various organ-on-chip models to investigate various organs and diseases. We would like to show you how we make these chips, what we do with them, and give some examples of organs and diseases we study. To be able to work with the chips, we first have to make them. The fabrication method of the chip depends on the materials that are used, and we will show you a few examples of our methods. To replicate small features, lithography processes are usually used, where the shape of the chip design can be transferred onto our material with a thin film of light-sensitive plastic. This plastic mask can then either be used as a mold, where for example PDMS can be poured into, or to directly etch into the material, like silicon or glass. After the PDMS has been cured, it can be peeled off the mold, and after activating the surface with oxygen plasma, it can be bonded to a glass bottom. The channels that were molded into the PDMS are now closed off by the glass. Now that the chips are fabricated and sterilized, it's time to add the cells to them. Cells can be obtained from immortalized cell lines, directly from the patients as primary tissue, or from induced pluripotent stem cells. These cells could be frozen or isolated fresh from tissue obtained from the hospital. Once isolated, the cells can be added into the chip, simply by pipetting. The chip might need to be coated with extracellular matrix before the cells are added, so that they feel more comfortable in this strange new environment. Once the cells are acclimated, they can be perfused with media and kept alive for up to a month. When the cells are inside the chip, we need to know if they feel at home, if they are doing well. For that, we use sensors to monitor how the cells are doing. After the chips have been made and we know that the cells are happy in their new environment, the research can start. Various assays can be carried out to answer different research questions. Here we can have a look at the vessel on chip that ESR10 is working on. With their advanced imaging technique, they can inspect the individual cells that make up their three-dimensional vessel. Now let's hear some of our ESRs explaining their chips.
Hello, I'm Merve. I'm working as a PhD student at Leiden University Medical Center. Here is the vessel-on-chip platform we use in our lab. I'm working on modeling human blood vessel diseases on this chip. We can generate patient-specific engineered vessels and study the disease mechanisms.
My name is Alessia Moruzzi and I am ESR1 in the Loskin lab at the Fraunhofer Institute. With me, I have an example of the chip we are using to generate cardiac microtissues and assess their functionality. The novel aspect of our chip is that you can load the cells by centrifugation, and here I can show you an example of blue colored water loaded into the chip by centrifugation. This chip design allows us to image up to 8 replicates of beating cardiac tissue at the same time.
My name is Matilda Kaminska and I'm a PhD student at Jena University Hospital. I'm also ESR number 5 and part of the EUROoC. For my research, I'm developing a better model of the intestinal system, and I'm doing that using human induced pluripotent stem cells. Stem cells like these can be isolated from skin of patients. Then they can be inserted and grown on microphysiological chips, such as this one. Finally, we can then have a patient-specific model that both enables disease modeling, but also specific drug testing for that patient.
Hi, my name is Mara, and I am a PhD student in the Wilmes Lab. My work aims to study gut microbiome interactions and to investigate how gut microbes can influence drug metabolism processes. For this, I use a gut on a chip that we call HUMIX, which stands for Human Microbial Crosstalk. HUMIX is modular, which means that it can be opened up after each experiment in order to extract the supernatants of the cells and the bacteria and to analyze which proteins they express.
Remember the dream from the beginning where you could simulate your body on a chip? With this video, we have shown you how we are working towards this dream at the moment. We hope that we can replace as many animal models as possible with organs on chip in the future, for the animal's welfare, for better science, and for your safety.